day and what's the next big trigger?
Well, I think at least till the budget, the trigger seems to be good enough because, you know, you had this credit policy and we saw all kind of things happening yesterday in the markets. And I think in a run-up to the budget, a similar kind of scenario could be played out where a lot of rumors will fly thick and thin. And whether they're right or wrong, that's a different proposition. But market is in a mood to really absorb some of these rumors, which will be viewed very positively, whether it's reforms, whether it's mines, whether it's natural resources, or whether it's PSUs. I think all those kind of things. So I think the big trigger, of course, is the budget. And at least till budget, I think markets will hold its level. And possibly, I think it will still be a buy on dip kind of a scenario at the moment. And markets probably are looking to spread out in terms of this sector.
Clearly, one space that has grabbed a lot of eyeballs is the energy space, PSU stocks. A lot of heavyweights also have contributed to the recent rally, the likes of ONGC, Coal India, Reliance Industries. Is there anything that you like there? And from a fundamental basis, how are you viewing the space?
Well, I think within the stocks that you mentioned, I think Coal India and more particularly, I think some of these oil marketing companies, whether it's HPCL, BPCL, or maybe to some extent even ONGC, I think some of these stocks look pretty good. And when I'm talking about looks good, of course the stocks have run up quite a bit in anticipation of everything. So my time frame has now become something like, say, almost about 15 to 18 months before you can say that you can get a reasonable appreciation. So with that time frame in mind, I think a couple of these companies look pretty interesting. And I think more so even from the PSU space, apart from Coal India, even BHEL or even BEL looks pretty good and interesting to really acquire on a long-term basis.
Dilip, you've been a veteran in terms of analyzing PSU banks, and there's lots that's happening. More importantly, the news that came out yesterday about a holding company structure, and while there's a lot of clarity still awaited, but do you think these are steps in the right direction? And how positive are you on these PSU banks, be it large ones or be it the smaller ones?
I think a couple of aspects on this. One is that the consolidation in this space is what everybody is expecting will happen sooner than what all of us think. I think that probably will be the step in the right direction. And I think once you're going to consolidate, it will have a lot of strategic value also getting unlocked. That is one. I think second part, of course, is the recapitalization which is required for some of these banks. And I think some of these banks will be able to attract a good amount of capital. So, you know, whether it would mean that you have to bring down the government equity below 50%, I think those are some of the very, looks like steps which can be achieved without really any major hurdle. So, you know, banks getting capital and being able to grow. And in a scenario where we all of us think that the worst is behind us and that better times are likely to come, that also will get reflected in the NPAs, the improvement in the asset quality, and more so all these PSU banks which has been the main problem for all these banks. So I think taking that into account, I think these PSU banks look pretty good and interesting, and they're still not expensive even when you compare it to some of the private sector banks. So whether it's Union Bank, Bank of India, whether it's UCO Bank, I think some of these banks look pretty good. Of course, SBI is the big bank which one should really play on.
Some of the banking names, but Dilip, if you look at most of the mid-cap, the small-cap funds, they've clearly outperformed the frontline indices by over 40%, I think, in the last 4 months or so. Which of the names do you think have deep value, which is yet to be unlocked from the broader markets?
So I think on a broader market, so if one were to come away from the Nifty 50, I think there is couple of names like there is a Jindal Steel, which probably, you know, it is still trading at a significant discount to its average valuation at the moment. And, you know, the 52-year low was somewhere around 235, 240, and at around 310. that stock still looks pretty good and interesting in that space. And you know, they were mainly afflicted, of course, because of some of the controversy, but largely because they were not getting the natural resources. So clarity on that probably is what we all feel is expected. So I think Jindal still looks pretty good and interesting from that perspective. I think some stray name, something like a Century Ply, also looks pretty good and interesting. And I would also bet behind something like a KEC or something like, say, a Kalpataru. I think all these stocks probably in that space, they are still available at very reasonable valuation. And maybe on a sustainable basis, these have a good long-term stories to unfold.
Okay. Dilip, what about media as a pack? There's a lot of activity here, technical as well as newsworthy. Editors moving left, right, center. Z Entertainment, there is FDI being allowed. And a lot of people say that the space, the good times of the space will now come over the course of the next couple of years, possibly even FDI. You never know. Have you scanned this pocket? Because there are multiple facets to media. There's distribution, there is print, there is television, there is exhibition companies. Have you liked anything here?
So Neeraj, I think in the front line, of course, we like Z. I think it's a good long-term story to bet on. And I think the tailwind is, of course, provided by the removal of cap on the FI investment in that. But that's a company, that's a stock which can generate a good amount of free cash for next couple of years. And we like that on a longer term basis. I think TV18 is another stock where we feel that maybe 3 to 4 years down the line, we'll see EBITDA reaching almost about 1500 to 1700 crores. So that's another stock which we feel has a good potential to really move up even from the current levels. I think in the print media, HT looks pretty good and interesting considering the cash that they have on the books and even considering the growth rate that we are talking about, and valuation-wise, it's still available within the reasonable levels. So these three look good. This TV also looks good slightly on a longer-term basis, but people are tracking that more on a quarterly basis. But slightly on a longer-term basis, I think they'll be able to generate good amount of cash to fund their expansions.
Yeah. Have you looked at NBFCs? And I want to speak about particularly in SKS Microfinance. I don't know how closely you look at it, but it's been a turnaround which has been spectacular. Now rules are changing for them as well. There's a new government in the state of Andhra Pradesh. So the signs are good. They have been successful in raising a large sum of money that they needed to as well. Do you like SKS Microfinance as a story from here on?
So we are not tracking this company very closely, but of course, the way they have taken the hit, I think what you said, one is definite that the change in the state government will help. But I think now they are much more beyond just Andhra Pradesh or the two states combined together. But I think more important is that RBI probably was looking at making some broader changes, which would probably have made, which would have helped the microfinance companies quite a bit. So I think that probably got postponed. So with the new government, and maybe that particular thing also can see the light of the day. But SKS, the way it is priced, it has moved up, of course, and they have raised the money. I think slightly on a longer term basis, that looks pretty good and interesting. And that's a concept which can really work in the changing environment and times.
Okay, Dilip, we'll leave it at that. It's been an interesting conversation. Lots of stock ideas and sector preferences is what we've garnered over the past 5 minutes or so. Thanks so much for taking time out and joining
us. Thank you.
Okay.